Hi guys, Aris, Hard God Busters. Is the Arctic P14 Max the best 140mm FEM? The P14 Max is the larger version of the P12 Max that I have already evaluated. Like its smaller dimension sibling, it promises high performance without breaking the bank. Moreover, its price is very good in the US market, where you can find it for only $13 on Amazon. While it is a bit more expensive in Europe, where it costs 18 euros, but with VAT included. The 5-pack package is a better option, since the price per fan drops notably. The fan speed is PWM controlled from 400 up to 2800 RPM, according to Arctic, and there is also a 0 RPM mode, which is activated when you dial 3% PWM speed and lower. I got the 5-pack package from Arctic. It comes in a plain cardboard box with stickers depicting the product specifications and other interesting info, including a QR code leading to the user manual. The fan's build quality is high. It equals fans with double the price. Say I remove the logo so you don't know the brand and the model, and I give this fan to you along with another $20 to $25 price fan. You won't be able to tell the difference easily. The only thing that might ring a bell is the lack of a daisy chain option. The increased power consumption might lead to this decision, but an adapter including a SATA connector for power would easily solve this. A similar adapter to the one that Superflower provides with its mega cool fans, which are power beasts. There are rubber mounts on the corners for reduced vibrations. Arctic provides a scheme of the bearing. From the shape of the bearing, you can easily figure that this is a Rife bearing and not a fluid dynamic bearing fan. Still, it is superior to a plain sleeve bearing, and under normal conditions, it can outlive the extended warranty. Test methodology. I use a fan performance measurement apparatus to evaluate cooling fans. This is a highly sophisticated scientific instrument made in Taiwan by Longwin. Besides the Longwin machine, I also use a Heyman anechoic chamber and a highly sophisticated and super expensive noise analyzer by Bruel and Kerr. Performance. The fan's maximum speed is the highest among all 140mm fans I have evaluated. However, it loses notably in maximum performance to the Superflower Megacool. You should keep in mind that the latter has an increased thickness of 30mm versus 27mm of the P14 Max and a stronger motor, which has 2.2 times the power consumption of the P14 Max at full speed. In airflow, the EK loop FPT also achieves a slightly higher reading, but loses by large margin in static pressure. Output noise. Although it has the highest rotation speed, it isn't the noisiest one. The Superflower Megacool is way louder at almost 53 decibels, and the EK loop FPT follows at 45.1 decibels. Noise increases at the 70% PWM setting. Frequency plots. 10% fan speed. There is no significant frequency spikes with a fan spinning at this PWM speed. 25 fan speed. Strangely enough, the 125Hz frequency is way lower than the others. 50% fan speed. The highest spike is at 160Hz. 75 fan speed. The 160Hz spike is again the highest one. Full fan speed, the frequency spike is at 250Hz, with a 160Hz frequency being also loud. Signal recordings of all these PWM settings that I've just described to you. Normalized noise tests, 20 decibels, noise output, top speed, high enough airflow, top static pressure, low power consumption. 25 decibels noise output, top speed, high airflow, top static pressure, low enough power consumption. 30 decibels noise output, top speed, high enough airflow, top static pressure, low enough power consumption. 35 dB noise output, top speed, top airflow, top static pressure and high power consumption. 40 dB noise output, top speed, top airflow, top static pressure, high power consumption. Advertised vs real performance. In this table, anything in red means bad news, while the blue fonts are the good ones. Speed is higher than the claimed one, while power consumption is increased. Airflow is way better than advertised, while static pressure is close to the Arctic's reading. Lastly, I couldn't find any official noise output reading, so I didn't have a reference point. Epilogue: the Arctic P14 Max is a fantastic fan with high quality and outstanding performance. In pure numbers, it might not be the best performing 140mm fan. This title belongs to the Superflower Megacool, which is thicker, so it has room to accommodate a stronger and way more power-hungry motor. But if you look at the normalized noise test, the P14 Max easily claims the title of the best 140mm fan. You have a killer deal if you combine the top performance with a highly affordable price, especially in the 5-pack package. There is no need to look elsewhere for a 140mm fan from the moment the P14 Max is available. I don't know how Arctic manages to hit the competition's pricing scheme so hard, but I do know that there is nothing out there right now matching the P14 Max performance per price ratio. At 25 dB normalized noise output, low enough not to annoy most users but still providing high speeds to offer decent performance, the P14 Max achieves a very good airflow reading while its static pressure is pretty far from the rest of the fans. The Inwin Neptune AN140 also has a pretty good performance at this noise level despite its budget price. Both Lianli's fans perform well in their respective categories, but none of them achieves high performance in both categories, airflow and static pressure. At the same time, their prices are sky high, especially the price of the Unifan TL LCD model. At $13 for the single fan and $60 for the 5-pack, the P14 Max is a steal. My only complaint is the lack of a daisy chain option. Some users might also want RGB lighting, but I'm not one of them. When someone provides me with such a high performance fan at a bargain price, I just say thank you and nothing else. Before I close this review, I would like to ask Arctic to improve the PWM's secret speed reporting function at some point, since again, I couldn't get steady speed readings from the Corsair Commander Pro that I used. So I had to use a tachometer to obtain speed information. The speed signal might need some filtering, but I didn't have the time to hook the fan to an oscilloscope to check it and see what was happening. If you need a top performance and highly affordable 120mm fan, look at the P12 Max. To check all alternative fan offerings, read my best cooling fans article before investing in new cooling solutions. You help me a lot, guys, by using my affiliate links, which don't increase the product's price. That's all. Thank you for reaching here to the end. Bye-bye.